Apple Silicon Macs are very powerful and capable of delivering high performance. After trying out Ubuntu on a virtual machine on Apple Silicon, I was amazed by the performance. If the virtual machine is delivering peak performance, then imagine Ubuntu running on a bare metal. This is Ubuntu Linux running on M1 Mac natively. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Ubuntu on M1 or M2 Mac. This is a step-by-step installation tutorial, so make sure to watch the video till to the end to avoid any confusion. Now, as you can see, this is my MacBook Air with an M1 chip running the macOS Monterey. To install Ubuntu Linux on M1 or M2 Mac as a part of a dual boot, you need to reserve a free space of 80 GB or higher. Next up, make sure your Mac is connected to faster internet and has a sufficient battery juice. Before installing Ubuntu on Apple Silicon Mac, open the terminal and type this command. Now look for the internal drive and remember these four partitions related to macOS. Just take a screenshot that is needed in the last step. Then open your browser, head over to this GitHub page of Ubuntu Linux and go through this page to learn more about this project. At the time of making this video, Ubuntu Linux is in the early stages. Anyway, copy this line of code, then paste it inside a terminal. Now run this command to execute the installer script. It uses the Asahi Linux installer and prompts you to enter the sudo password. Now go ahead and remember the macOS username. In my case, it's M1 Mac. Then press the Enter key to continue. Then type N to skip the expert mode. And you can see the information about the macOS and the related partitions. The type R to resize the macOS partition to make a free space for Ubuntu Linux. You can shrink the new size from your existing partition by entering the size in percentage or gigabytes. The best way to shrink the free space for Ubuntu is to type MIN for minimum, and the installer will figure out the required space for Ubuntu. Now, as you can see, out of 100 GB, the installer allocated 66 GB for Ubuntu Linux, then type Y to continue. Now, this will take some time, so please be patient. Now, go ahead and press the Enter key to continue. Now, as you can see, this is the free space we have allocated. Then type F to install the Ubuntu Linux in that free space. You will be allowed to choose the Ubuntu version. Now, as of now, you can install Ubuntu 22.04 LTS and 22.10. It's better to choose Ubuntu 22.10, which supports hardware-based acceleration. I'm going to choose option 1 to install the latest version of Ubuntu with a GNOME desktop. Then confirm the installer to use the free space that we allocated by typing max. Name the Ubuntu Linux and press the Enter key to start installing. Now this will take around 15 to 30 minutes, so sit back, relax, and grab some drinks. Now, as you can see, the installation is complete and you will be prompted to enter your macOS admin password. Now, at this point, we are done with the first step and you can see more instructions for step number 2 to complete the installation of Ubuntu. Now, read these instructions and follow me carefully. Now, this is where you need to be very cautious. Now press the Enter key to shut down your Mac. Wait for at least 20 seconds. Then press and hold the power button until you see a message saying loading startup options. Now this will take you to the One True Boot, which shows all of the bootable volumes that have an operating system. Now using the arrow key, select Ubuntu Linux and press the Enter key to boot into macOS Recovery. Go ahead and choose the username and enter the password you use to log in into macOS. Now as you can see, the terminal has opened and waiting for user input. Just press Enter key to continue. Now type the password for the macOS administrator for one more time to change the boot policies. Then type Y to confirm the changes. Next up, enter the username and password of macOS to complete installing Ubuntu Linux. And voila, now you can see the installation is complete and press the Enter key to reboot. Now this will boot your Mac into Ubuntu, which is running on bare metal. Now go ahead and set up the Ubuntu Linux for the first time. I'm going to connect to Wi-Fi, then open the terminal and type this command to update the package list. Now type these commands to install the Firefox browser. I just want to say in one word, Ubuntu on Apple Silicon is mind-blowing. The performance is top-notch when compared to Intel Mac, but considering the fact it's an early build, some of the things like FaceTime camera, microphone, and sound from internal speakers are not working. To know more about Ubuntu running on Apple Silicon Mac, just go ahead and watch my review video and check the link in the description down below. Now to switch between macOS and Ubuntu, first turn off the Mac. Once it completely goes black, press and hold the power button until you see a message saying loading startup options. Just remember, when the Mac is turned off, holding the power button for 10 seconds will take you to the boot menu where you can see both macOS and Ubuntu entries. You can choose Macintosh HD to boot into macOS. Now, this is a perfect dual boot setup on Apple Silicon Mac with Ubuntu and macOS. When you are inside macOS, open the startup disk and change the boot order. You can choose macOS to boot automatically. As a bonus part of this video, if in case you decide to delete Ubuntu from the dual boot, just boot back to macOS. Then open the terminal and type diskutil space list. If you notice under the internal drive, partitions 3, 4, 5 are the main volumes of Ubuntu Linux. I'm going to bring up the screenshot that I took while installing Ubuntu and compare it with the current partitions. Now, out of 3, look for Ubuntu EFI partition. Now, in my case, disk 0s4 is the identifier of the Ubuntu EFI partition. Now, in your case, it may be different. Just note down the identifier and erase the partition. To do so, type this command and provide a valid partition identifier. Make sure to provide the correct identifier, then press the Enter key to erase this volume. Then head over to the Disk Utility. From the menu bar, choose View and select Show All Devices. Now from the sidebar, choose Apple SSD and click on the partition. Now, these are the 3 partitions of Ubuntu. Delete them one by one. Do not touch the first and last 2 partitions. Now, once it's deleted, the free space will be added back to macOS. Now, if you reboot your system, it will boot back to macOS. And that's pretty much it. This is how you properly install Ubuntu Linux on M1 or M2 Mac natively. For detailed instructions, head over to my website for step-by-step installation instructions. Check the description for more information. Thanks for watching this video. This has been KSK Ryle. I will see you in the next one.